President John Kennedy's debut on the international scene gets off to an auspicious start in France with his arrival at the Paris airport after a flight from New York. The president is greeted formally by President Charles de Gaulle, with whom he will hold a series of conferences before those with Soviet Premier Khrushchev in Vienna. It is a meeting of the heads of two great nations that have been friends since the birth of the United States, a dramatic, symbolic scene of unity, the aging great man of France and the youthful president of the United States. From the airport, there's a procession into Paris through her historic streets and past enduring landmarks. Crowds estimated as high as 2 million line the route to cheer the president, escorted by crack units of the Republican Guard. The two leaders lost little time in discussing their major problems, and barely before have heads of state come to such quick agreement on some points. Even before luncheon, they conferred and dealt speedily with the Berlin situation, committing both countries to a firm defense of that divided city. Their first private conferences are held at the Quai d'Orsay and at Élysée Palace. Mr. Kennedy later made a strong statement on the interdependence of France and the United States and pledged that American forces will remain in Europe as long as they are required, ready to meet any threat with whatever response is needed. Later, the two men took up the Southeast Asia and African questions, laying a firmer foundation for a united front on these vexing problems. Mr. Kennedy will carry with him to Vienna and Khrushchev all of the prestige that his meeting with de Gaulle has produced.